Thank you so much, everyone, for being here today. What an honor it is to be with you. So I have to really quick share this. 6 years ago, I came to my first leadership retreat, and I remember sitting in the back thinking, I am going to be on stage speaking one day. And I remember shutting my eyes and embodying that emotion and visualizing being up here. And it's just good to know that intention and manifestation followed by action really does work. So first, I would like to give a little bit of my backstory, because actually, before we go to that, before any of my classes, what I like to do is do a little bit of deep breathing with an essential oil that's calling your name. And today, I would like you to pick an oil, go into your bag or backpack, pick an oil, something that you're gravitating towards right now that's going to help you shift from a scarcity mindset to a mindset of abundance. Maybe it's wild orange, maybe it's litsia, blue tansy. But as you're deep breathing, just set that intention of creating that positive shift, going from a negative to a positive. Okay. So my intention today in these next 15 minutes is to help you go from a scarcity mindset to a mindset of abundance. And first, I would like to share a bit of my backstory, because sometimes you need to hit rock bottom in order to know what you're truly capable of. I would love to introduce you to my absolutely gorgeous mother, Donna. She is the guiding light in my journey and in my sister's journey, who's sitting right up here up front with me. As you can see, she's absolutely stunning. She's a health nut. She was a hardcore bodybuilder back in the 80s, and just the most genuine soul that you could ever meet, and the most amazing and incredible mother and best friend. At age 58, my mother unfortunately was diagnosed with a rare lung disorder, and they gave her 6 months to live. This completely shocked us, of course. There was no cure for this disease. The only way that she was going to survive this was through a double lung transplant. But because of having my sisters and I also pictured up there with her, as you can see, she looks like the fourth sister. Because of having my sisters and I, she developed an antibody that only 17% of the population in the world had. So essentially, we were waiting for the perfect set of lungs from an earth angel in that 17%. And we were waiting on a miracle. And unfortunately, it was not my mom's time. And she passed away. Suddenly, almost 6 months to the day of her diagnosis. Now, for anyone that has lost anyone, you know, grief can be almost unbearable at times. Not only did I lose my mother and my best friend, but 48 hours after she passed, I found out I was carrying my third child. So I was trying to manage the grief of losing my mother and also stay healthy for the baby that was growing inside of me. So it was some trying times, to say the least. A year and a half had gone by, and I could not find any type of support in my grief. My hormones were all over the place. I was a new mom of three, and I had officially hit rock bottom. This is really hard to admit, but I could not even find joy looking in my children's smiling faces. I was in a pit of darkness, and I could not find my way out. And I remember one night I was doing the dishes, and I was sitting there, and I was kind of having a pity party in my own head. And I was just thinking to myself, why me? I was so happy before. Why am I so sad? Why can't I find my light? Why can't I find this joy that I used to have? And I remember something switched and I heard my own voice. But not only did I hear my own voice, I heard the voice of my beautiful mother, and then I also heard the voice of Heavenly Father say, girl, you need to get your act together. Only you can take care of you. You've got a husband that loves you. You've got three boys that need you to show up the best version of yourself. It's time to take charge of you. And it was at that moment I decided I was in charge of my well-being. I was in charge of my own health. I stopped doing the dishes, I popped onto Instagram, and I saw a post by my friend Danielle, one of my mentors and very best friends, that said, leadership position available. And I had this fire in my stomach, this gut instinct. I had no clue what that meant. I had never used an essential oil before, did not know anything about the business, but I had a deep gut instinct that this was going to be a part of my life that was going to help me on my wellness journey. So I dove headfirst in. I fully entrenched myself in my everyday life with natural tools, dove headfirst into the business and started sharing. And I kept waiting for those lows to come back, those low feelings. But I kept on finding so much joy and abundance through helping other people. What I decided to do was turn my grief into a catalyst to create positive change within others. And it kept on fueling my soul. And I found a light inside of me that I literally didn't even know existed. You know, I've hit the highest of highs and lowest of lows. I hit diamond in under 2 years and fallen back to silver. I had 100% close rates at classes for years, and then I couldn't get anyone to show up for classes. I've had incredible business partners, and then I've had legs completely fall apart that I've had to rebuild. But one thing has remained true. I found a way to turn those negatives into a positive. I've found a way to take those scarcity thoughts and turn them into thoughts of abundance. Woo! And the best part about this, guys, is it's literally within us. Everyone can do this. It's all within inside of our hearts and inside of our minds. And that's what we're going to go over today. A few simple tools for you to take your own circumstances and your journey and take those scarcity feelings and move them towards feelings of abundance. So first, let's go over what is actually scarcity and what is abundance. When you think of scarcity, what are some of the words that come to mind? Is it fear? Is it lack? Is it limitation? Is it success in others means less for you? This is a scarcity mindset. Now, when you think of abundance, it even just sounds nicer. What words come to mind? Living in flow, joy. There's so much joy in abundance. Happiness, empowerment, focusing on the opportunities, okay? Abundance comes in the form of the physical, but it is so much more. It's actually the energy that you guys, that we all put off. Abundance is the energy that we give off. So I want you to start to think about your own aspects of your life. If you have a piece of paper in front of you, I would like you to make two columns. On one side, list all the aspects of your life, business and personal, that you think you have a really abundant mindset towards, that bring you peace and happiness, that feel like you're living in flow. And on the other side, I would like you to list all the things that you feel like you have a scarcity mindset towards. Maybe they bring you fear. Maybe you're in comparison. So living in abundance doesn't mean you base your stability off external factors. It means you shift your perspective and believe in the potential at your fingertips. Guys, there's so much potential at our fingertips. It lights me up inside. So I want you to just start to acknowledge that scarcity column And let's start to put our energy towards that so we can start focusing on shifting those. How many of you here are looking for business partners? Woo! I think if we're building our business and we're here, we probably all are, right? So how many of you wish you could find a business partner just like yourself? High belief in the company, high belief in the product, high belief in the opportunity at your fingertips. Not going to give up when times are tough. Sounds like an amazing business partner, right? Sounds like you. But how many of you have business partners on your scarcity list? Finding business partners. How many of you feel like the person that I just described that sounds like me, I don't attract those people. Those people aren't out there for me. I am never going to find those people. Guys, this isn't a scarcity mindset. This is the mindset we have to shift, because if you just painted the picture of yourself up here and your qualities as a business partner and someone found you, there are other people out there like you that have the will, the ability, and the potential. It's just the shift of a mindset. Okay, so when something goes wrong, what are your first thoughts? Victim mentality, why is this happening to me? Or seeking solutions and opportunities, this is happening for me. I want you to start to shift from why me to this is happening for me. Maybe it's a growth opportunity. Maybe you need to grow through something, not go through something, but grow through something in order to help a business partner down the road in the same scenario. An abundant mindset is a way of reflecting on events and circumstances in an optimistic way, seeing all the opportunities and possibilities. Everything is happening for us, not to us. And you win some and you learn some. So how do we actively shift from scarcity towards abundance? First, I want you to acknowledge that list that you have in front of you, and let's just consciously put our focus there so we can start actively shifting. And I'm gonna give you 5 simple tools that you can do on your own, in your own mind, to help you create that shift. Number 1, find joy in your own health journey. Guys, we literally have every single tool in the toolbox to fill our own cups. Use your oils, take your supplements, take your collagen, make it light you up. How can you find joy and abundance in your life and attract that if you're not feeling good, mind, body, and spirit? And this is going to include movement and music, okay? Never underestimate the hardcore power of a great dance-off in your kitchen, okay? To your favorite music. Find that music, find those tunes that literally light your soul up and create a playlist. So when you're feeling lack or you're feeling limiting beliefs, put on the playlist and have that music help shift your energy. Feed your mind with the good stuff, okay? Our thoughts are so powerful. I want you to start to rethink the narrative that you are telling yourself. Speak kindly to and of others. Remove the negative people from your life. Remove the negativity from your life. Listen to inspiring books and inspiring podcasts. Here are some affirmations that I love. Try recording these on your phone and listening to them throughout the day on your downtime. Or if you really want to up the ante of it, look at yourself in the mirror and say these to yourself. And this first one is a massive favorite of mine. I am a magnet for miracles. And I would love for us all to say that together. You guys ready?
Yes.
Okay. I am a magnet for miracles. How good does that make you feel inside? Doesn't it jazz you up when you say this stuff? I love affirmations. Gratitude journaling to find your inner peace. Your abundant mindset is what truly brings you peace and happiness from the inside. Go to bed with a grateful heart, focusing on all the things that you do have in your life rather than what you don't have. And the best part about that is it's going to be on repeat all night long. It's actually proven that people with gratitude, that people that are grateful, get better sleep, they're happier, they're more content. And here's one of my favorite blends for you to try as well. Serve and give to others. By giving freely, you're setting the intention that more is always available. Guys, this is actually why we do what we do. We are advocating for other people's health. So when you're feeling funky, which we all do, or where you're feeling lack, wake up and say, who can I serve today? Who can I help today? I'm sure we've all had a scenario where we've shared a tool with a customer and they've come back to us and shared a win with us, and it made us feel so good inside. Get out there and do that again, and do it over and over. Don't keep your unique talents and abilities to yourself. Go out and serve with them. Lastly, visualization. This is so important. Is there any futuristics in the house? Okay, so you guys know we visualize a lot, almost on a daily basis. And the most important part about visualization is embodying that emotion that you are desiring. Just like I did 6 years ago when I was embodying being up here. Feel those feelings. So when you're feeling lack, visualize gratitude, visualize abundance. Whatever abundance means to you, visualize moving towards that. When you visualize something, your brain actually responds like you're doing it, and you're just training yourself for the real thing. And if anyone needs a good blend to encourage visualization, this is my high vibe blend. I highly recommend it. Makes you feel awesome, incredible. So we all might find ourselves in a scarcity mindset here and there, but what matters most is that we have the will and ability to shift away from that. And this is something that we all have inside of us. So I'd like to leave you with a quote from my mother's journal that brings me peace and abundance, and I hope it brings you peace and abundance as well. All that I need will come to me at the right time and place in this life. My mom, Donna. Thank you so much. Woo!